Thanks to Babbel, a language learning app, for sponsoring this episode. If you're interested in growing your language skills, SciShow Space viewers get up to 65% off with a 20-day money-back guarantee when you use our link. The search for exoplanets is one of the hottest areas of astronomy right now, and one main reason for that is because humans are dying to know if there are other Earth-like planets out there, and whether or not they might host life. But sometimes researchers are interested in exploring the other end of the spectrum, planets that are nothing like Earth. These planets can give us an idea of what extremes are possible out there in the universe, and offer us insight into how planets come to be and how they evolve over time. Some of the most fascinating planets are the incredibly hot ones. So today, we'll take a look at three of the most blistering hot worlds ever found. The first is a planet called TOI 2109b. It is a huge gas giant in the constellation Hercules, 855 light-years away. The planet is 5 times the mass of Jupiter, but unlike our Jupiter, it orbits extremely close to its star, which is just a little bit bigger and hotter than our sun. The planet circles its star at a distance of about 2.6 million kilometers. Now, that sounds like a long way, but it's basically a stone's throw in astronomical terms. That's just under 5% of the distance between our sun and its closest planet, Mercury. It is so close that its entire year is 16 hours long. When astronomers first discovered huge planets like this so close to their stars, they were confused. Because in the early days of planet formation in a stellar system, it's just too hot near the star for such a big planet to form. The material needed for the core is too hot to be solid, and the gas needed for the atmosphere is too hot to be captured. So this planet and others like it must have formed farther out, like Jupiter, but migrated inward. And now, because of its proximity to its star, the day side of this so-called ultra-hot Jupiter is around 3,300 degrees Celsius. That is at least 1,000 degrees more than the night side of the planet. And this temperature difference is believed to drive ferocious winds across the planet, making the skies of this world a pretty horrific place. But while this planet gets almost hot enough to melt diamonds, it is not even the hottest planet out there. That distinction goes to another giant known as KELT 9b. This planet orbits a star 670 light-years from Earth, and it is also a ultra-hot Jupiter. It's more than 3 times as massive as our Jupiter, and its orbit is around twice as big as TOI 2109b's. Now, since it's farther from its star, you might expect it to be cooler, but KELT 9b orbits an absurdly hot star. The star burns white-hot, and at about 10,000 degrees Celsius, it's around twice as hot as our sun. That gives KELT 9b a scorching temperature of 4,300 degrees Celsius. It is a planet hotter than most stars. And that temperature would melt pretty much anything. Even high-tech hafnium carbide, the material on Earth with the highest known melting point, would turn to mush on this planet. It's actually so hot that astronomers think molecules of hydrogen in its atmosphere get ripped apart on the day side and reform on the slightly cooler night side. This extreme cycle likely won't go on for too long, though, at least not in astronomical terms. The searing heat is evaporating the material that makes up the planet, and observations show that the intense radiation from its star seems to be blasting away these evaporated gases, almost like a comet's tail. So in a few hundred million years, the planet may be no more than a husk. Now, it's hard to beat KELT 9b when it comes to extremely hot planets, but we'd be remiss if we didn't give a little shout-out to a hypothetical exoplanet known as Kepler 70b. Astronomers found what could be the sign of a planet while they were observing the star Kepler 70 in the constellation Cygnus. They picked up some periodic dips in the star's brightness, which is a pattern that can happen as a planet passes in front of its star and blocks a little bit of light. This is actually one of the most common ways astronomers discover exoplanets. And in this case, these dips suggested that astronomers were possibly looking at a gas giant circling its star so closely that it made a full orbit every 6 hours. But measurements like this are really tricky. Detecting a gas giant passing in front of a star is like detecting a mosquito passing in front of a car headlight over 100 kilometers away. And follow-up studies using different detection methods have suggested that these dips in Kepler 70's brightness are just natural variations, not the signature of a planet. So the planet 70b likely doesn't exist after all, but if it did, it would be the hottest planet ever discovered at over 7,000 degrees Celsius. Now, none of the planets we've talked about today are even close to being anything like even near habitable. But the existence of these extremes gives us an idea about the variety of planets that can exist. And they are a reminder that we share this galaxy with some incredible worlds. Learning a new language requires a lot of time and commitment, making it difficult to quickly get into conversations. But if you are as impatient as I am, Babbel can help you start speaking fast. Babbel is a language learning app that helps you use a new language in real-life situations after only 5 hours of practice. They're the number one language learning app in the world and currently offer 14 different languages. Their short 10-minute interactive lessons are designed by real teachers, not computers, so whether you're looking to brush up on your skills for a summer adventure abroad or gain a language skill to help you with your professional development, Babbel will help you learn about both the language and the culture that speaks it. As a SciShow viewer, you'll get up to 65% off when you sign up using our link in the description. Plus, Babbel comes with a 20-day money-back guarantee, so you can see where Babbel takes you on your language learning journey.